Hi students, this is T. Balakrishna, Chemistry Lecture, GPT Kothagudem. Today our topic is galvanic cell. A cell which electricity generates due to spontaneous oxidation reduction reaction is called galvanic cell or voltaic cell. The cell which is generated the electricity by the spontaneous oxidation reduction reaction is called galvanic cell or voltaic cell. In this cell, the chemical energy is converted to electrical energy. So which cell is convert the chemical energy into electrical energy? That cell is called electrochemical cell. So this cell is called as galvanic cell or voltaic cell or electrochemical cell. The cell which generates the electricity by the spontaneous oxidation reduction reaction is called galvanic cell. That means this cell is generate the electricity. It is also called as electrochemical cell. This is the diagram representation. So right, next one, galvanic cell or voltaic cell. We discuss about the construction of galvanic cell or voltaic cell. The galvanic cell consisting of two half cell. See the diagram, it's consisting of two half cells. In this two half cell, one is called as anodic half cell, another one is called cathodic half cell. So in this cell, it consisting of two half cell. In this two half cell, one is called anodic half cell, another one is a cathodic anode half cell, and another one is a cathode half cell. So come to the anode half cell. In this anode half cell, zinc rod dipped in aqueous solution of zinc sulfate solution. So it is in first half cell. In this half cell, the zinc rod is dipped in aqueous zinc sulfate solution. The one rod, metal rod, is that rod is zinc, is dipped in zinc sulfate solution. Come to the second half cell. In the second half cell, copper rod dipped in aqueous solution of copper sulfate solution. It is a second half cell. In this half cell, the copper rod, metal rod dipped in aqueous copper sulfate solution. Is clear? It is consisting of two half cell. In first half cell, zinc rod dipped in aqueous zinc sulfate solution. The second in second half cell, the copper rod dipped in copper sulfate solution. Next one, the two metal rods, zinc and copper rods, are connected with a copper wire through the voltmeter. So observe this diagram. It's in a zinc raw metal rod and this is in a copper metal rod. Both are connected by the help of copper wire through the voltmeter. So both are connected by the help of copper wire through the voltmeter. Okay. Next one, the two half cells are linked through a salt bridge.
The two half cells are connected with the copper wire through the voltmeter and also connected linked with the salt bridge. So you observe this, the salt bridge is in a U-shaped tube. It contains KCl and ammonium nitrate. KCl or ammonium nitrate, a gelatin gel solution. So this tube is filled with KCl chemical or ammonium nitrate chemical. This is the construction of galvanic cell. Is it clear? It consisting of two half cell. First half cell is filled with zinc rod in zinc sulfate, and second half cell, copper rod dipped in copper sulfate. Both the metals are connected by the help of copper wire through the voltmeter, and salt bridge is dipped in the salt bridge in a U-shaped tube. It contains KCl or ammonium nitrate solution. Next, come to the working principle. The zinc and copper rods plates are connected with the copper wire through the voltmeter. The oxidation takes place in this zinc off cell, and reduction takes place in this copper off cell. So we got one doubt. Why the oxidation takes place in this zinc off cell rather than this copper off cell?
So zinc is highly reactive than copper. So which metal is highly reactive, that is ready to lose the electron? So zinc is tends to lose the electron more rapidly than copper. So zinc is ready to lose the electron. Losing of the electron is called oxidation. So the oxidation takes place in this part. The in which part oxidation takes place, that part is called anodic oxide. We already learned in electrolytic cell principle, oxidation takes place at anodic part. So here oxidation is takes place, so this part is called anode. So in which of cell anode is present, that of cell is called anodic of cell. So this of cell is called anodic of cell. So reduction takes place at second of cell. So here copper is ready to gain the electron. So reduction is takes place in second of cell. So this of cell is called cathodic of cell. Reduction is takes place at second of cell. So this is called cathodic of cell. So this is an anodic of cell. This is a cathodic of cell. Why do we call this an anodic of cell? Oxidation takes place in this of cell. So this is called anodic of cell. Reduction is takes place in this of cell. This is called cathodic of cell. So here, anodic. Why do we call this an anodic of cell? So oxidation is takes place. So oxidation is takes place. So oxidation means losing of electron. Here zinc is ready to lose the electron. So zinc is ready to lose the electron. Zinc is converted into oxidation means losing of electron. Zinc is converted to zinc plus 2 by losing of 2 electrons. Zinc is converted to zinc plus 2 by losing of 2 electrons. So oxidation is takes place. So these electrons are transferred from. So zinc is converted to zinc plus 2 by losing of 2 electrons. These electrons are transferred from anodic part to cathodic part by the copper wire. These electrons are transferred from anodic part to cathodic part through the copper wire. These electrons are reached to the cathodic of cell. That electrons are gained by copper plus 2 ions which are present in the electrolytic solution. The copper plus 2 gain that 2 electrons is converted to copper. So this is a working principle of galvanic cell. So zinc is converted to zinc plus 2 by losing of electron. That electrons are transferred from anodic part to cathodic part to the copper wire, and it reaches to the cathodic part. The copper plus 2 ions which are present in the electrolytic solution, that copper plus 2 gain the 2 electrons is converted to copper. So this flow of electron is called electricity. So this cell is generated the electricity. So you remember the important point here, electrons are flow from anodic part to cathodic part, that is called flow of electron. Flow of electrons means electricity. So this cell is generated the electricity. How much amount of electricity is generated represented in this voltmeter, 2 volts, 3 volts, 1.4 volts, 2 volts, how much amount of energy is generated, that is represented in this voltmeter. So this is the working principle. And after some time, both the off cells are, for in this off cell, zinc off cell, zinc is totally converted into zinc plus 2. This off cell is totally converted into positively charged off cell. So zinc is converted into zinc plus 2. It formed zinc plus 2 ions. So this copper plus 2 is converted to copper. So it requires only sulfate ions, negative ions. That means this off cell is totally converted into positively charged off cell. This off cell is totally converted into negatively charged off cell. Okay, this off cell is converted into totally positive charge. This off cell is totally converted to negative charge. So due to the accumulation of charges in the two solutions prevent the further flow of electrons. Hence, the reactions in the cells are stopped if salt bridge is not used. So in this case, if it is in particular time, it is totally converted into positive, it is totally converted into negative. It does not generate the electricity due to the accumulation of charges. So if you, in this case, the salt bridge play an important role. Here salt bridge play an important role. What is the role of this salt bridge? It prevents the physical mixing of two solutions but allows the ion from one off cell to another off cell. So here it is filled with this salt bridge is filled with KCl or ammonium nitrate gelatin.